A very good afternoon to all of you. So I am here for discussing the duty ratio control of output voltage. So when we come to the duty ratio control of output voltage, then there are two things that we can do. Yes. Before that, first of all, I would like to shed the light on time ratio control and current limit control. Yes. So basically, by two methods, we can control the duty ratio of the output voltage. Why it is important? Why we need to control the output voltage? Output voltage needs to be varied. Yes. Because of the different applications in which our converter will be, to which the our converter will be subjected to. Okay. For example, the converter may be subjected to becoming the interface between a solar power plant and the battery bank. Okay. It may be subjected to as an interface between a hybrid electrical vehicle, where it can be used to be a subsystem consisting of a power plant interface, in which the power will be transferred, and it will be transferred from high voltage side to the low voltage side. Okay. Now, coming back to the duty ratio control of output voltage, again, the first control that is very easy and interesting to follow is the time ratio control. What is the time ratio control? We all are well versed with the term, that is the time ratio control. The on time. In the time ratio control, the on time is controlled. Yes. That is the duty ratio D, which gives T on by T, is varied, and this helps in the control of the duty ratio. And this time ratio control can be achieved in two ways. First is the constant frequency, as it is stated in A. What happens in constant frequency is that basically frequency and time are having a explicit relation. It means there is a direct relationship between frequency and time. And that is nothing but upon the variation of frequency, the time will vary. Yes. Or the frequency is inversely proportional to time. So we can say basically that frequency variation can be kept to constant. It means the time will remain constant. So only one thing will vary, and that is the on time. The on time T will vary. Are you getting it? The on time T will vary, but the original time will remain constant. This is known as the classic case of pulse width modulation. What it is called? The classic case of pulse width modulation. It is very, very important. Pulse width modulation. Second thing, the variable frequency. In the variable frequency, what happens is that the frequency will be varied. So, in response to the variation of frequency, I can say that as the frequency is variable, so the time period will vary. So one more thing that can be very much stated about the variable frequency method is that as the time period is varied, then obviously the switching on and switching off duration, despite keeping the duty ratio constant, the switching on and off duration will vary. So we can very well say that there cannot be a constraint on the losses. The losses cannot be controlled. Okay, this is nothing but frequency modulation control. Now coming to the current limit control. Basically, current limit control deals with the hysteresis band. The thing is that the current will vary in between a prescribed band. Is that clear? Okay, there will be a set maximum and minimum level of voltage, and in which in this time the chopper in the DC-DC converter will be switched on and off, so that the current remains well between the upper and lower limits. Okay, and we can very well say when the current is above the maximum or it is below the minimum. Are you getting it what I'm telling you? That it has to be above the minimum, maximum, or no, it has to be below the maximum and above the minimum. Are you getting it? That is the limit. That is the hysteresis band in which it operates. So if it is it is below the maximum and above the minimum, then for sure we can say that the chopper will remain on. We can understand that it works more or less like a Schmitt trigger. More or less like a Schmitt trigger means that Schmitt trigger, we can very well say that when the transition point comes, yes, when the transition point is there, then it has to remain in its state. Okay, for example, the upper threshold is at 6 amperes. So whenever the current tries to go above 6 amperes, then for sure our switch will be turned off. Okay, is it clear how the switching off and on of a switch is carried on? Okay, when the switch is in its off state, as it is written here, you can see well there it is, that when the switch is in its off state, current freewheels via diode. Okay, it will freewheel through the diode and then it will discharge in an exponential manner. Obviously, the discharge will be exponential. It will follow I naught max e to the power minus t upon RC. Okay, this is clear. After that, when the current reaches the minimum level, the chopper is switched on. Okay, so the current has to be maintained between a band, and that band should be there. Okay, are you getting it? The current will remain intact inside a band. Okay, this is what we are discussed in current limit control. So now have a look at this. I had discussed the maximum and minimum value of load current. Now I will come to one more point, that is this thing. Yes, analysis and waveforms. You can very well see that this is the inductor current. Okay, this is the inductor current and this is the voltage. Okay, so inductor current minus output current will give us the capacitor current, and corresponding to capacitor current we can plot the capacitor voltage. Okay, so this is a very important discussion. I will see you in the next lecture. Please keep studying, keep smiling. Thanks and have a good day.